The first thing you need to do when considering treating for emerald ash borer is to ensure that you indeed have an ash tree.
Wisconsin is home to four species of ash trees: green, white, black, and blue. Most ash trees in yards or as street trees are either green or white ash. You can identify true ash trees by the opposite branching pattern and compound leaves, typically with 5 to 9 leaflets, as shown in the diagrams to the right. If you happen to have a mountain ash planted in your yard, you'll be relieved to know that mountain ash is not a true ash tree and is not attacked by emerald ash borer.
The second step in the process of treating for emerald ash borer is to measure the circumference of the tree so that you can determine the amount of product that you need as well as the amount of water that's required. The next step is to remove the mulch or the bark that's surrounding the base of the tree to a distance of about 18 to 24 inches so that you create basically an inverted volcano, so that when you apply the material it will stay within that area and it will move or infiltrate down into the soil and be absorbed by the roots. The next step in the process in treating for emerald ash borer is to select a product. For demonstration purposes only, we've selected the Bare Advanced Tree and Shrub Protect and Feed, which contains both imidacloprid and clothianidin, as well as a fertilizer. The Bare Advanced label requires 1 gallon of water for trees 50 inches in circumference or smaller. And consequently, because our tree is 22 inches in circumference, we will be using 1 gallon of water to apply our Bare Advanced product, which we will measure out in just one moment.
Before we measure out our Bare Advanced product, here are a few quick notes about pesticide safety. Before using any pesticide, read all of the directions on that product's label. Make sure to follow these directions precisely. This includes wearing adequate personal protective equipment such as gloves and keeping children and pets away from the treated area. Many products available today for homeowners come with some type of measuring device. Keep in mind that any measuring device, bucket, watering can, or other container that comes into contact with a pesticide should not be reused for other purposes around the house.
And now we will measure out the appropriate amount of Bare Advanced product that is applied to the ash tree that we'll be treating. Because the circumference of the tree was 22 inches, and the label requires 1 fluid ounce of product per inch circumference, we have poured 22 fluid ounces of the Bare Advanced product into the 1 gallon of water that we measured out previously. Next step in the process for treating for emerald ash borer is to physically apply the solution of the Bare Advanced product and the water around the tree in a circular manner in the area where we've pulled the mulch back. The final step in the process for treating for emerald ash borer, once the material has had the opportunity to infiltrate into the soil, is to replace the mulch back over the area where you removed it around the base of the tree.
When it comes to timing, spring is the ideal time to treat your trees for emerald ash borer. However, research has shown that fall applications are also effective. Treating your trees may be most appropriate if you live in a county currently quarantined for emerald ash borer, or if you live within 15 to 20 miles of a known infestation. Insecticide treatments are most effective when applied to healthy trees. Applications to stressed or injured trees may not be effective. Protecting your trees early yields the best results. Lastly, remember that every tree and situation is unique. Your county extension agents are excellent sources of information for maintaining the health of your yard trees.